What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up, Grocknation? Welcome back to another edition of Grock Plays Valorant in the arcade this evening. Hope everyone's doing well, staying safe out there. Really hope you guys enjoyed my winter fragrance selection video I uploaded earlier this evening. I told you guys I wanted to get a Valorant gameplay whisper to up as well, as I haven't uploaded anything really for almost a month, so I want to get a couple of videos out for you guys. This particular game happened earlier this evening. I see about 6 p.m. I got the matching snaps, as you can see. So once again, guys, if you're new to this channel, hit that subscribe button and to give it a thumbs up if you like the video. Helps others find my content. Especially my gameplay video fans out there. If you want to see more videos, we do have a lot in the playlist, so go ahead and take a look. Okay, guys, so this is, I think, four games out of my placements. I decided to give Valorant another try after essentially quitting during the fall winter as solo queuing just became unbearable, and I invested more time in League of Legends, but I decided to give it a try, and it turns out I'm still pretty damn good at it. I played it right before the season ended and got myself to gold, and then I went back to playing League, so I finished the season in gold, and it placed me in Silver 1, which is where we're sitting right now. See, my record for the day at this point is 1-0. I'm actually gonna eat a candy cane here, guys, while we talk, if you don't mind. I love candy canes. It's one of my favorite things about Christmas. So my Valorant fans out there can definitely join me in celebrating the return of Split. This map actually was removed from Valorant Queue sometime in the late summer, maybe midsummer, to give it a rework. And they brought it back with, I think, just minimal changes. It really doesn't. It still feels like Split to me. Sorry, I had to skip ahead a second. The stream froze for some reason. I just killed the person and I got a second one right there.
You guys are insane.
It's kind of the annoying thing with Twitch. I think it's when the audio needs to kick back in. So I have some music playing that gets DMCA'd, and that's why there's no sound at the beginning for the first minute and a half or so until the sound kicks in. I think when that happens, it stalls the stream or the VOD. My apologies, we should be good for. But as I was saying, Split is definitely a welcoming addition to ranked play. We lost Bind, and they're going to redo Bind as a desert map, which is my favorite Breach map. But I'll take Split over Bind any day. I always loved this map.
Walls coming down.
You guys can see my awesome Grockstar sign behind me in my arcade. My fiance got it for me. I'm absolutely in love with it. It is such a great looking sign. It makes my arcade look so nice. So what I've been finding in Valorant lately, I've been having incredible luck. I think I had 12 straight wins last week. Season ended. I think it's because I'm so invested in League now. I don't take Valorant as serious as I used to, I think is why. I just feel I play a little more looser, and yeah, like like tonight. I went 5-1 and we ended in a draw in my last game. Because I placed gold to give me ridiculous amounts of XP to try to get me out of this elo. And even though we drew, I got plus 16. I kind of want to let you guys kind of guess how much I get for this game. It's pretty ridiculous. Actually surprised my friend Reggie when I showed her how much I got for this game. These type of games, this and League of Legends, both made by Riot Games. They have seasons for the rank play where you redo your placements and everyone gets, you know, bumped down and they gotta regrind back to where they were. What happens in games like this is you place lower. And it'll actually give you extra XP and whatnot for wins to try to get you back to where you were and get you out of this elo. You guys can see from this one game, I'm not meant to be Silver 1. Silver 1 elo, you're playing with bronzes, sometimes irons as well. And sometimes the matchmaking, it's just not fair. This happened on two occasions this evening. And on two occasions, we played against a team that was significantly better. We drew one, like I said. Mind you, there was an AFK in that game. That's why we drew. He decided to leave us because he had to go. We were up immensely, and they came back. We ended up drawing after two overtime rounds. But the other game, they dominated us in the first half. We came back in the second half. They had a Smurf on their team, as did we, so kind of evened out. But those are really two of the only grindy games. The rest of them were pretty easy tonight.
I hear mid.
I don't know what it is. I kind of got this sad feeling that I won't be playing Valorant much longer. Even now, in this video, you can see the look on my face like I'm not too enthused. I'm not really trying hard or anything, it's just, I'm kind of going through the motions. There's a really, really nice skin in a battle mass. There's weapon skins with four of the female agents on them. One of which is Fiber, which is my main character. And I'm really playing because I want to get that skin. I want it unlocked in the battle pass. Once I get that unlocked, I could see myself, I could see myself maybe one more time in the league again. This is my big mistake of the game that I kind of kicked myself in the ass for later. With the time running out, he planted and he baited me basically. Because I assumed he was going to plant. He wasn't. He was waiting for me to peek. I bet you anything if I hadn't swung, he never would have planted and he would have lost just on time. But, I got a little anxious there and trying to go for the kill.
I could have played that better.
Guys, you guys probably know this in these VODs. I'm constantly upgrading my cam box and my graphics for it. This is a jet graphics I came up with for Valorant. Those are Jets. That's Jets icon and a Grockstar logo, and that's Jets booty. I got off of Etsy on either side. Jet, if anyone plays the game, probably has the smallest butt out of all the agents, but I figured it would match my nicely.
Wall down.
So at this point, I think we've all been there, all of my Valorant players.
No, you don't.
Once you start to get crazy, you really don't stop. You really push angles you wouldn't push normally. Just really start to get some swag going, and I can't believe she was sitting in that corner the entire time and she just looked at me. I don't know how I didn't notice that till now. That's how he died. But you start to get some swag, and you start to not respect the opposing team. And I've been on the opposite this as well, where I'm telling my team that's playing super cautious that, you know, they're just pushing us heavy because they don't respect us anymore. This is the new badass Vandal that I, I actually don't run this game, I think. Again, something in Valorant is, you shouldn't be changing up what's working. Right now what's working is Phantoms for me. As you can see, I'm 13 and 2 at this point. See, I don't want to mix it up. So those of us that haven't watched a Valorant gameplay before, or haven't seen my previous videos, Valorant is a 5v5 competitive shooter in the same nature as CSGO, Counter-Strike, aka you plant a bomb and you fear the opposing team, you defuse it. And you switch after at least 13 rounds, 12 rounds. You switch sides, and it's the first team to 13 wins the game. Exact same style as CS:GO, the same same weapon sprays and everything. It's CS:GO mixed with Overwatch, I think, is what they were trying to go with here. And it's actually really taken off. It's overtaken CS:GO in terms of views on Twitch. It's got a really, really big competitive scene now, especially in North America. And like League of Legends, which is huge in Asia. This game is really big in North America. They got the Champions League starting this year. Character I'm using is Phoenix. He's a duelist. He's got a kit meant for fighting 1v1s, 1v2s, being the first to push in. The characters in League, Valorant, are really, they're like based off of like fantasy kind type things for the most part. Their powers are inspired by them. Spike down. Like my character Phoenix. He's like a pyromancer. He can form fire. There's a character in here that's
one coming heaven.
Well, the character, I the theme of my webcam, Jet. Planted. She can manipulate wind. Things of that nature. There's quite a bit more of it, and some of them are just super soldiers. This Reyna is like a vampire, I believe, is what she is. She's like a soul leader. Yeah, so they all have their own unique little abilities. The blue chick on my team, you can see. She's in the top middle part of our team bar there. That's Neon. She's basically a complete ripoff of Sonic the Hedgehog, right down to the blue spiky hair. She's a duelist that can really run like massive dashes and slides, and it's really, really good for mobile people that are mobile or like mobility. Sorry. She's really good for that. You really need to have reflexes for that. I was so bummed out I didn't get the kill joy. So fun fact out there, this beautiful kill joy that just died. They actually made her character come out as a lesbian. The duelist Raze, which is on the other team. The black female character with the orange hat. They had them come out as a couple last month, and it pissed off a lot of people. People are actually getting mad over video game characters' sexual orientations. It's absolutely ridiculous. Who cares? Who cares? I mean, I agree in the sense that there's no story to the game. It's just a first-person shooter. I mean, who cares? Like, why even bother making any of them in relationships to begin with? It doesn't make any sense. But in the Valorant lore, those two are dating now. And, it was comical watching people get angry about it. Threatening to boycott the game and all sorts of crap. It was so funny. My favorite character, my big crush in the game, obviously, is Viper. She's the American scientist. All these characters are from all over the globe, by the way. Viper's the American scientist. She's in her mid-30s, and she's just the ultimate MILF. She's got that leather outfit and those sexy curves. Oh my god. If they had a Viper booty emote on Etsy, it would be Viper's theme and not Killjoy's. But sorry, Jets, but it is what it is. Jets more like a... They built her like a free runner. She's more like a free runner kid. Killjoy's more like... She's the German computer tech, basically. Got the Russian, I think he's supposed to be like a sniper. He's like a, he has a bow. Sova, the one-eyed Russian. And they have Omen on their team, which is a failed science experiment. I think they were attempting to make a super soldier or something in the lore. It was actually Viper and someone else, and they made him the way he is. They fucked up the experiment and made him the way he is, which is this ghost man, basically a smoke man. They have little voice lines in there in the game that pertain to it when you have the same characters on the same team, or if they're on opposing teams. It's really... Some of the voice lines in this game, I'm not gonna lie, are pretty fucking cringy. But, yeah, this is just a small sample. I guess I never touched up on Fade. Fade, the gray-haired beauty between Neon and Viper on my team. She has like a... Like a symbiote almost. It's almost like Venom. It's kind of a ripoff of Venom is what they're trying to go with her. This like oily, sticky substance that she can manifest and they do all sorts of certain things. Like she can make an orb that can act like as a camera, basically can tag people. She can mark people and then use these, I don't know, floating cool things to go and find them. She's the second or third newest character. They just added an Indian character from India, Arbor. He was the last one. And he's, he manipulates water him. That's his power. So they almost have everything, covered. They got Breach. He like manipulates the earth, like earthquakes and stuff. Some stuff like that. Seismic crap, I don't know. But yeah, that's just an example of these characters in the game. I just wasted my ult because it was the last round before the half's over, so. It's Phoenix's ult is he can make a form of his entire body and control it. It's basically a free, free death and you get to come back. So right now we're up comfortably 10-2. Never, ever, 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 ever in Valorant, assume you got a game in the bag. If you're going Grock, why are you up? You're at like a full rate. It's because I'm listening to some music in between. I threw the intermission screen up and I have some music playing and I just chill. Answer my phone, etc., etc. This gun, actually, you guys, is Jinx's weapon from League of Legends. Again, because Valorant and League are made by the same company, the skins that intertwine. There's been a lot of weapons in Valorant that are from League of Legends. And this is one of them. This actually came out when Arcane, the League of Legends Netflix show, premiered on Netflix. They had an Arcane bundle, came with a Jinx buddy, some sprays, and then you can buy the gun that I bought, or pistol, and it came with the little Fishbones buddy, which is her rocket in League, her bazooka. Her Q in League, and it's one of the most sought after weapons in terms of people selling accounts because it's so rare it'll never be sold again. My friend Denise is messaging me wanting to play. I hadn't played with her in a very long time. She's my friend from Winnipeg. She's usually tries to play in the mornings. She has a little girl, so she tries to play around that. But yeah, they have a ton of other skins as well. They're inspired by League. They have a Smite skin set. Weapons that are designed to look like the Smite items the junglers use. They have a Grocknation set. Like the ruined set from League of Legends, they have weapons that look like it, including the sword, the blade of the Ruined King, which is, as we all know, a legendary item in League of Legends. So yeah, they intertwine them quite well. I'm eyeballing match MVP here because I'm still just out of my placements, and I know, like I said, you get extra XP for performing well after your placements because they try to put you back where you want to be. So, if I can make a suggestion to anybody coming out of placements or even doing placements, when you're doing them, try to pick a duelist or someone you know you're going to get a lot of kills with, because really, I messed up that queue. Firing squad there regardless, because you want to get as much points as possible. It helps your placements and it helps how much XP you're gonna get. So yeah, always try to see. There's that venom like go. Don't pick a support, help you in the end. And I kind of messed up. I played a lot of supports and it bit me in the ass. I finished my placements, 3-2, and I placed me silver 1, so we won this game 22-6, and I'm not sure where our assists were. We did amazing regardless, and now we moved to 2-0 for the day, so I'm curious to how much I'm going to get here. I got the MVP, which I knew I would get, the match MVP in that, and it gave me plus 46 and bumped me to silver too, so it really wants me out of silver. I'm sending a picture to my friend Reggie because that's crazy. But yeah guys, that's gonna be it for this video. Nice little quick League of Legends, not so much commentary, but just chit chatting with you guys about this particular game, and hopefully putting you guys to sleep, making you guys relax. And yeah, that's what these videos are for. So, with that guys, that's going to be it for this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, like I said. Hope you guys have a great day, great night, whatever it may be. And peace out. Thanks for watching.